I don't know if you know who Eamon Agalarov is, but he is the pop star son.
Everyone knows who that is.
Yeah.
Stop the presses. You know about Eamon, your buddy Eamon, who looks like a friend of mine, actually. It's really uncanny. but he was the pop star who was involved in that like meeting with the Trumps and the Russians and everything. He's released a music video that seems to really be trolling everyone. It's called like You've Got Me Good. Mm-hmm. And we have it exclusive. We're gonna watch it and they'll be able to hear us as we react to it. So let's just do it.
Are we doing like our own R. Kelly?
Yep.
Wow.
Trapped in the closet.
This song, I'm not gonna lie, is a little catchy. So that's supposed to be Hillary Clinton and they're all playing poker. Yeah. And then there's Ivanka as well. Mm,
this is interesting. Throwing down the purse.
And then there's some like spy lord that's overlooking it all. It's unclear. Yeah, big brother.
Don't you trip out at the cinematic quality of these like parody videos? They spend some money on this.
He's a real pop star.
Yeah.
And he's got a good voice. He's got like a Robbie Williams vibe.
A little bit. Yeah. Like a bit of like, I'm a pop star dad kind of thing.
So weird.
And then it's revealed at the end that it's Kim Jong-un that's been watching it the whole time. It's
so meta.
It's very strange.
I mean, what do you do with something like this?
I think you just gotta, he's obviously trolling and he got us good. I mean, people are talking about him as a pop star. They're playing, they have to listen to his music in order to watch the video in order to comment on it. So he did get us all
good. Is this gonna be the new Gangnam Style?
Absolutely. I'm in. I'm fine with it.
He's gonna get a billion views.
Right. and just, you know, sidebar, he's hot as hell, so I definitely watch this video repeatedly.
He looks like a man. He looks like any guy. You think he's hot?
Like a buff Seth MacFarlane, does he not?
I do see that.
What do you see, Jack?
I think more like buff Ari from Entourage.
Jeremy Piven.
All of these are great comparisons. And you would never think that that person would be a pop star, a huge Russian pop star, and yet here we are.
I really like he could have totally subverted democracy, changed the election, but there's something about that smile where I'm like, he seems like a nice guy.
Yeah. You
know, why not?
Brett, I know you thought that you presented the hot story in music, but no, you're wrong, because I'm going to be telling you about a rapping priest, the saga of this rapping priest, and why the Catholic Church in Kenya doesn't want him to continue rapping. It's actually quite sad. So there's been a priest who's been suspended by the Catholic Church in Kenya because he engages in rapping some of his sermons to bring the youth closer to the church, and the Catholic Church, the diocese, has said that they don't want that. They said, yes, the church has taken disciplinary measures against Father Agalo. The use of rap music is not allowed in preaching. He's still allowed to attend worship and he can participate. He just can't lead worship in the same way that he was doing before. Now, he's actually a bit of a star in Kenya and he's been seen as kind of a revolutionary. So Twitter totally came to his defense. And some people are saying that this makes the Catholic Church look dictatorial. What? The Catholic Church? No way. Now, what's interesting, and I do want to point this out, is that he does sermons like normally, as you'd expect, just preaching from the pulpit. And then later on, he'll switch and he'll put on like a bandana and then he'll like do a bit more of a rapping, like fun youth service. This is just, I mean, to me, this is just what many churches do. It's very weird that this is so controversial. What do you guys think about this?
Totally. Like, I mean, what? Well, if they're following that rule, shouldn't they still be doing sermons in Latin?
Yes.
Exactly.
Right.
All
right.
My gosh.
What if it was like a compromise? We'll rap. We'll rap in Latin for you.
There we go.
Is that okay?
It's a challenge.
How did they feel about Sister Act?
Right. You've got some great points.
They made another one out of school. No, they're teaching.
And now it's on Broadway.
Yeah.
I think you can't tell people how to worship. You can't tell people, you know, what's going to invoke the Holy Spirit, be it music, rapping. Mm-hmm. So I think it's cool. I mean, I grew up going to Baptist church and where there's a choir, and the majority of the 2-hour sermon was people singing. They have praise dancers, praise worshiping.
Yeah.
So I would love to go to church and have them do like Rapper's Delight, like the hip hop, the hippie to the G-O-D, you know, that'd be off the chain.
It's so true that like young people feel, and anyone, especially like as a member of the queer community, the church totally pushes you away and it feels so inaccessible. So for him, he's just trying to bring in young people and to try and bring them into the church. He feels like he has a good message going on. My dad one time did a sermon based with only Jennifer Lopez lyrics. I can't remember exactly like what it was, but he like crafted a sermon around my love, don't cost a thing. It was something something about how, like, you know, money isn't important, it's like love. I don't know. But I'll have to find it. But like this, you do these things to try and engage with people.
I actually had a friend who, you know, I've been in 12-step recovery for a very long time, and I once had a friend do an entire share from the podium only using Steven Seagal movie titles. Like,
what?
My Life Was Under Siege.
How many
and like,
movies are there?
There's like 8 or 9. Right. And he basically did this whole 3-minute thing using Steven Seagal movie titles. So exactly like your father.
Yeah,
like,
what did your dad
just
say?
Like that.
You think you gotta keep me iced? You don't?
Yes.
Even if you were broke, my love. Don't cost a thing.
He ain't just Jesus from the block.
Yes.
Oh my God.